Bukit Timah Cluster House, condominiums or landed properties, which one make the most money? Hello everyone, today I'm going to do an in-depth review of cluster house in Bukit Timah. I will then compare them with condominiums and landed properties in the same area. The purpose of this study is to determine which asset class perform better in the long run. In the video, I will also share where are the property lobangs in the Bukit Timah area. They are worth considering. So please pay attention to it. Here, do you want to make a guess which property will outperform and which will fare the worst? Will it be the freehold Ventura Heights or 99 years 11 at Holland? Or will it be the 6th Avenue residence condominiums in 6th Avenue? Then, what about the typical landed properties in Namli area? Let's make a guess. If you can guess it correctly, this means you are as good as me. Let us head straight to my property tour through my morning run. Hi, my name is Alan from Alan Wee Property. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. As usual, I started on my run in the morning. Do you know I exercise easily 3 times per week? That is why some of my clients commented that I hardly age and look younger with each day. By the way, I'm already in my early 40s. Let me share with you a secret of keeping youthful. Firstly, get enough sleep. Secondly, reduce stress. And thirdly, and most importantly, go for regular exercise. That's the key. Simple as ABC. Here, the first cluster house I want to discuss is Ventura Heights. Ventura Heights is located along Jalan Lim Tai See off 6th Avenue. This 40 units freehold cluster semi-detached house were launched in 2008 to 2009. They typically measure about 4,000 to 7,000 square feet and comprise 3.5 story with a basement car park. Back then, the average price was hovering around $666 per square feet. Today, the average price is $800 per square feet. This worked out to be a capital appreciation of 21%. Not too bad, but not too fantastic in my opinion. The next project is the 39 units freehold Astridville located next door. This cluster house comprises mainly semi-detached house and is also along Jalan Lim Tai See. Similarly, most of the units measure about 4,000 to 7,000 square feet and comprise also 3.5 story with a basement car park. When it was first launched in 2009 to 2010, the average price was $690 per square feet. Today, the average price is $660 per square feet. This means the capital return is almost negligible. As I run along Jalan Lim Tai See, I'm greeted by Hun San Temple or Hun San Gong. This temple is dedicated to the deity Lim Tai See and was established by immigrants from Fujian, China in 1902. Lim Tai See, born in 1537 during the Ming Dynasty, was well respected for his stand against corruption and commitment to social justice. During the 1950s and 1960s, the temple organized regular Chinese opera shows which were performed on a theater stage near the temple. This show attracted villagers living in the area, including Malay residents from the neighborhood. Today, Hun San Temple and the nearby Masjid Al-Huda continue to maintain good relations and often exchange gifts of food during special occasions, such as the Lunar New Year and Hari Raya Puasa. The temple was awarded conservation status by the Urban Redevelopment Authority in 2009. Interestingly, on the temple ground, there are a row of inter-terrace known as Hun San Court. They are built without any car porch or gate. Anyway, I couldn't find any transaction on them. Who knows, they could still belong to the owner that owned this piece of land. As I run along Jalan Ampang, I came across Estrivillas. Estrivillas is an 18-unit condominium built in the 1985. Both of the units are huge. They measure from 2,000 to 4,000 square feet. Here, there are only one transaction that was sold in 2022 at 3.15 million or 1,573 PSF. brother and sister here, can buy or not? Obviously, this kind of project don't even need to think. As I run along this beautiful estate, these are some photographs that I took during my run. I love to take photos of beautiful houses, whether they are new or old. Some houses are beautifully designed, while others are old school but still charming. Next, I reach Shamrock Villa through a shortcut via Longkang. This cluster detached house is located along Namni Place. It's next to Namni Park and is pretty far away from the main road. Nevertheless, this 11 units development was launched in 2010 at 741 PSF. Today prices are still the same at 738 PSF. Surprisingly, prices have stagnant over the last decade. The next cluster house is Palm at 6th Avenue. Obviously, it's located along 6th Avenue. Palm at 6th Avenue is the newest cluster house in the Bukit Timah area. The typical design is 3.5-story with a basement car park and 2 parking lots. They are also counted in the built-in area. This 32 semi-detached house were launched in 2013 to 2015 at 1,100 per square feet. Interestingly, today prices are hovering around the same. Frankly speaking, if I'm the owner there, I also shake head. Just take a look at the profitable transaction. They don't make a lot anyway. Levin at Holland is a 99 years leasehold cluster house along Holland Link. The lease starts from December 2010. This means the remaining lease is a good 86 years left. This 82 units development was launched in 2011 to 2013 at 1,000 per square feet. But only a handful of units were sold to date. Today price is around 730 PSF. Prices had declined 31% over the last decade. But if you look from another angle, price look attractive to me, even if it is 99 years for the Holland address. The only concern is the reversionary land lease, which is likely freehold in nature, could still belongs to the next door Fun Yun Thai Association. In addition, their future government land sale just across the road. A Holland address will likely be 2,000 per square feet upwards. By the way, this development is in the news lately. You can read the case law here. I suppose after this legal case has ended, more units will be pulled up for sale by the developer. So, stay tuned to it. So much about cluster house. Let us recap and look into their performance to date. Except for Ventura Heights, that performed the best with a 21% return. The rest, such as Estrivilla, Shamrock Villa, and Palms at 6th Avenue, don't really fare too well. The 99 years 11 at Holland performed the worst with a 31% depreciation. I find it puzzling that cluster house underperformed in the Bukit Timah area. Why is that so? Is it because of the small floor plate and the high built-in area? Or could it be because of the high maintenance and the closeness of each unit? But take note, older cluster houses, they are spacious and are well designed, are highly sought after. One such example is Chestnut View, located in the upper Bukit Timah area. The house is only 2-story high, but comes with spacious bedrooms and practical living space. This means that design plays a part in any product. Nothing wrong with cluster house, it only boils down to their design. What buyers want are functional design. For developers and architects that are watching this video, please build practical and functional house that you will want to live in it yourself. The saying goes, you build and they will come. Notwithstanding that, there are some owners that can still flip for the profit if you enter low and sell high. This owner in Shamrock Villa made a cool $880,000 in just 4 years. He bought it in 2018 for $3.8 million. The original owner bought from the developer at $4.59 million in 2010 and incurred $790,000 in losses. So what can we learn here? This means that there is an opportunity to make money when others are losing money. So, please pay attention to loss-making deals. If you want to maximize profit, remember to rub salt onto their wound. So much about cluster house. Let me zoom just into two condominiums that are launched around the same time. Let us study their performance over the same time period. The 6th Avenue residence is located along Prime 6th Avenue. The 6th Avenue residence is a 175 freehold condominium development. It was launched in 2006 to 2007 at an average price of $1,000 per square feet. Today, prices have doubled to $2,000 per square feet. This is an impressive 100% return in 17 years. Floridian is further down Bukit Timah Road. It has 336 freehold units. It was launched in 2008 to 2009 and an average price of $1,300 per square feet. Today, the prices are 2169 PSF. Prices have appreciated by 67% in 15 years. Not too bad, but still decent. Let's go into Bukit Timah landed property analysis. I will just average out the price in terms of per square feet regarding the house condition. I will only use properties in Shamrock and Lucky Park as they are sufficient transactions to compare. I will use Shamrock Park, which comprises mainly freehold landed properties around Namli area. The average PSF in 2008 to 2009 was 1,605 per square feet. Today, the average price is 2,565 PSF. This means that Namli prices have appreciated by 141% since 2009. I also studied Lucky Park, which comprises Lasia, Lotus, Lemon, Lily Avenue. They are off 6th Avenue. The average PSF in 2008 to 2009 for freehold property was 967 PSF. Today, the average price is 2434 PSF. This means that freehold 6th Avenue prices have appreciated by 152% since 2009. This shows that Bukit Timah landed properties is a clear winner. As I always say, if you can afford to buy land, please go and buy land. You wouldn't lose in the long term. Land costs in Bukit Timah will never be cheap. Going forward, UOL will launch Watton Estate easily above 3,000 per square feet. So think again if land price will drop. If you are a landed property owner staying in Bukit Timah, will you drop your price? Let me further average out the cluster homes, condominiums and landed data. Overall, cluster home in Bukit Timah have underperformed with a negative 3% return. Or should I say, they remain flat over the years. On another note, Bukit Timah condo performed decently well at 83%. The best performance is the landed segment, where it outperformed by 146%. This means price has increased 1.5 times since 2008 over in the last 15 years. This means that landed property price in Bukit Timah has appreciated by 10% every single year. Here, I know some of you will say that I have not included more condo or landed in my analysis. I know the data I use are not comprehensive, but I hope you can understand that I did all this number crunching all by myself. There are a lot of work involved. It is practically impossible for me to cover all areas with limited resources. Nevertheless, I hope you find this analysis useful in your property investment journey. Anyway, if you are staying in the Bukit Timah area and have plans to sell your properties, you can always reach out to me. I will do my best to get the best price for you. I promise. Lastly, just some sharing after my run. I feel that Bukit Timah is a great and pretty awesome place to stay. It's very green and shady. NParks has did a great job. But most importantly, I feel very safe running there. This is one of the many reasons why property price in this little red dot shine. There is a cost to safety, all thanks to our Singapore Police Force in keeping our neighborhoods secure. Finally, let me reach out to our Law Minister, Mr. Shamugan. You did a great job as our no-nonsense Law Minister. You are the best of the best. That's all for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you and see you soon.